Playboys, Miss September 1980, Lisa Welch Semler. Miss July 1981, Heidi Sorensen. Miss January 1982, Kimberly MacArthur. Miss October 1989, Karen Foster. Miss June 1985, Devin DeVasquez. Centerfolds of the 1980s. Ready for action. Playing against Miss January 1976, Dana House. Playmate of the Year 1978, Deborah Jo Fondren. Playmate of the Year 1974, Cindy Wood. Miss May 1979, Michelle Drake. Playmate of the Year 1979, Monique St. Pierre. Centerfolds of the 1970s. On your marks. For Family Feud's monumental, earth-shaking Battle of the Centerfold. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cole.
Thank you so very much. Hello to the Centerfolds of the 70s. Welcome back to the lovely ladies and with the Centerfolds of the 80s. Thank you so very much. Are you excited to be here? Well, we're glad that you've tuned in at home. You want to call a friend. It's by your popular demand. It's back. It is the Playboy Centerfold Special. You've already met the lovely ladies. They're playing for great charities. The Centerfolds of the 80s, headed up by Kimberly MacArthur. Welcome back. Now, the team that wins today will play for the chance at $10,000 for their favorite charity.
That's right.
Who'd you pick?
We picked the Children of the Night, which is a terrific organization. What it does is it aids teenagers who have left home for one reason or another. It gives them shelter, a chance to call home, food, and sometimes just a sympathetic ear, but it's wonderful.
It's a wonderful charity, and I wish you luck. But I have to say, I noticed out of the side of my eye, five beautiful ladies who doubt that you're going to get that chance to play for that great charity. They are the Centerfolds of the 70s. That is by Dana. How are you, Dana?
I'm good. How are you?
Well, I'm doing a lot better. Dana House. Now, what charity are you playing for?
We're playing for Operation USA.
Yes.
And it provides disaster relief to 43 countries and the Persian Gulf.
Well, what wonderful charities. Who will play for the $10,000? We won't know until we play The Feud. Let's go! The first team to $300 will play for the $10,000. Good luck to both. The first question, we got the top five answers on the board. We ask 100 people this question. Try to find the most popular answer. Name a bad habit that can ruin a woman's... Go ahead there.
Smoking.
Let me see. Smoking. Name a bad habit that can ruin a woman's looks. Diana? Dana, I'm sorry. Let me just step over here with you. You can go right back there, Kimberly. Think of us. You're so lovely.
Oh, thank
but you,
you
make me feel inadequate as
would
a man.
You, would you wear my heels later?
I was going to ask you. I wouldn't wear them later. I will wear any piece of your clothing you'll let me touch.
Please,
it would mean a lot to me.
Shoes.
This is not a... How about this, huh? Makes me feel more like a man. You know what? They fit. Maybe I should get in Playboy. I don't know that. Hey, does that look all right or what? There you go. Look at you. See, this looks like a... Now, this is much better. Make me feel like a man, Dana. It's not exactly the piece of clothing I hope to get from you, but it'll work. Here we go. What's that? Sorry about that. You know, these pumps kill me. I'll get them on. Believe me, if you stretch mine out, you're paying. All right. Here we go. All right, Karen, I love these. A bad habit that can ruin a woman's looks.
Biting her fingernails.
Let me see, biting her nails.
Right.
Number two, said by 25 people. I'm starting to like this, which is scaring me. Lisa, welcome back. What would be a bad habit that could ruin a woman's looks?
Oh, God.
Pick a guess.
I can't do it. She took the answer that I had.
3 seconds. Take hers. That's one strike. Yeah. Think of a steal over there. Centerfolds of the 70s. Divine. Mm. It's Devin, I'm sorry.
Devin.
But the judge called you divine, and that's what made me say that.
That's very
well, thank you. A bad habit that can ruin a woman's looks.
Drinking.
Show me. Drinking. Bam! Seven people said it. Don't give up over there. Think of it. Hello, Heidi.
Hi, how are you?
I'm very fine. What do you say?
I say overeating.
Ooh, it can ruin a woman's looks. Good answer. If they are overeating. There it is. Whoa, 82. Hey, this is starting to hurt. $82 in the bank. Now, Kimberly, if you can give me number 5, it's a clean sweep, and it's a very good way to start the feud.
A bad habit that can ruin a woman's health or her looks.
Her looks. Please put your tongue back in your mouth. Don't do that.
Lack of exercise.
Lack of exercise.
That's good.
It's a bad habit. If you've got the bank, if we see a lack of exercise. Two strikes. Think of a steal, women of the 70s. Karen, you can take the bank. Bad habit that can ruin a woman's looks.
How about frowning? It gives you wrinkles.
Yes, sir.
It's a bad habit to frown. Not there. All right, women of the 70s. This is hard. You don't know how hard.
Whoa,
Monique, bad habit that can ruin a woman's looks. One answer. Doesn't know. Cindy, does not know. Michelle?
Pulling your hair, playing with your hair.
Playing with your hair. It'd mean a lot to me if you just stand straight up. There you go. Here we go. All right, Deborah Jo.
Parting too much, not getting enough sleep.
Parting too much. Tell her what you want her to say. Tell her what you'd like her to say. One answer steals $82. And I go right now.
I'm going to say playing with your hair.
Playing with your hair?
I'll
tell you what. If I see a beautiful woman and she's playing with her hair, icky, icky.
Don't you think that looks tacky?
That's funny. Okay. You're going to steal that bank if we see women playing with... To me, if a woman has hair, she's got a shot. That's the way I feel about it. Playing with their hair. No! The centerfold of the 80s takes the bank. We asked 100 average people. What'd you think, Michelle? What did you think? We heard different things.
And partying.
Not enough sleep, partying. Number 5. Can ruin a woman's tanning. Take note, women. We're coming right back. If you want to look good, come back after these messages. We are feuding Playboy Centerfold Special. $82 for the centerfolds of the 80s, the 70s, zero. Here we go, Deborah Jo, with another face-off. Deborah Jo. Top 6 answers are on the board to a question we ask 100 people. Stop looking at me like that. If you were told to evacuate your house immediately, what would be the first thing that you would grab? Karen?
Money.
Let's see. Money. It's there. 4 answers will give you control. Deborah Jo says the first thing she would grab would be clothing. All right, at the bottom of the survey, think of a steal. You think of a steal there, Deborah Jo. 5 people said it.
Lisa,
if you were told to evacuate your house immediately, what would be the first thing that you would grab?
My children.
Good answer, a fine answer. And I say, forget the clothes. All right, show me the children. Number 1, you would get your family. Said by 27 people. Devin, what do you say?
Come on, Devin.
Jewelry.
Would you grab your jewelry?
Good answer.
Well, I guess, now the question, if you listen to it, doesn't tell why you're evacuating. It just says if you were told to evacuate your house immediately, what would be the first thing you would grab, Heidi?
Animal.
Okay. Maybe you'd grab your spouse. Let's see if it made it. No, it's different. Your animals. Pets. 15 people said it. Kimberly, keep it rolling. Keep it rolling.
Come on.
I told to be evacuated, the first thing I would grab would be my boyfriend.
Really?
I can't.
It's funny.
Wouldn't
it surprise you if your boyfriend was like number 2 on the survey said by 14 women? Let's see. Her boyfriend. Not there. That's 2 strikes. Karen, what do you say? Keep the team alive.
That's a great guy.
How about some form of identification?
You might want to grab some form of identification. That is 3 strikes. Centerfolds of the 70s, that bank is yours. If you were told to evacuate the house immediately, what would be the first thing you would grab? One answer, Mooney?
Photographs.
Photographs, indeed.
I was gonna say keepsakes.
Keepsakes, Michelle?
My pants.
Her pants?
Food.
All right, Deborah, food? All right, tell her what you want her to say. 2 answers will get you in this game. What do you say?
No, I'm going to say
on your own?
Photos.
Photographs.
Definitely.
All right, well, I'll tell you what. If any of you don't make it out, I've got some of your photos over at my house. So, all right. Here we go. Think about it. That's a good joke. Show me for the steal. Photographs. Yes, sir. Centerfold. No, I'm not in trouble. We'll trade back here. Let me just get the... If you could help me get that off. There's one answer that would have absolutely kept you going there. Something you would have taken if you're told to evacuate the house. Number two for the women of the 80s. Purse, not said. We are coming right back. It is a real feud. Who's going to play for the $10,000? We'll find out after this. We're back. 82 for the centerfolds of the 80s. 53 centerfolds of the 70s. As we go with another face-off and double the dollar value. The top six answers are on the board. Listen carefully. We ask 100 people, tell me something that most men will never learn to do right. Michelle?
Put the toilet seat down.
Let me see.
Put the toilet seat down. Is that better?
Let me see. Put the toilet seat down. Didn't make our survey. Lisa? I hear men booing. Stop it or there'll be a fight here. Lisa, something...
That's a reality, though.
That most men will never learn to do right.
How to cook dinner.
How about how to cook dinner? Yeah. It is number three, think of a steal. Come on, think of your dog drinking, he has to drink. What do you say, Devin? Something that most men will never learn to do right.
Make love.
Well, settle down. It's most men. Thank God there's a few of us that know how to do it. All right. Let's see. Make love. Heidi.
Yes.
What do you say?
I say housework.
Could it be housework? Number one. $66 in the bank. Kimberly. Something most men will never learn to do right.
To be romantic.
How? Yes. How about just to be... romantic. Well, even though it wasn't there, it seemed like a good answer. Karen, there's $66 they're going to try to grab. What do you say?
Laundry.
What's that?
Laundry.
Laundry. All right, let me see. Laundry. Yes, sir. $112 and growing, Lisa. What do you say?
Oh, God, I might get in trouble.
You can say what you think. 100 people surveyed. Something men will never learn to do right. Some men. Most men will never learn to do right.
To watch the kids.
How about watch the children? Right. Three strikes and this $112 could be yours. Something that most men will never learn to do right, Monique?
Change diapers.
Change diapers, Cindy.
Say they're sorry,
Michelle.
Pick up after themselves.
Pick up after themselves. Deborah Jo.
Take care of the kids.
Tell her what you want her to say for the steal.
Pick up after themselves.
The centerfolds of the 70s.
Okay, we're going to say pick up after themselves.
You got $112 if we see pick up after themselves. You got it word perfect. Women of the 80s, these two answers would have kept you alive. Number four. Most men will never to understand about that toilet seat deal. And number five. Communicate. Well, let me tell you, it's 165 to 82, and we're going with another face-off. That's communication. Cindy and Devin, the dollar values tripled in the top four answers on the board. We ask 100 people, name something that you squeeze to get more out of it. Devin?
An orange.
Let me see an orange. That's number one. Think of a steal, Cindy, back with your teammates. The dollar value is tripled. Heidi, something you squeeze to get more out of it.
Your spouse?
I wish I were your spouse. Let me see. Your spouse.
That was a good answer, though.
It was a good answer. Okay, it is a good answer. Yeah. It threw me off.
I think the toothpaste tube.
How about the toothpaste tube? Either team can win this game, Karen. Something you squeeze to get more out of it.
A container of lotion.
All right.
A hand lotion.
Will you... let me see lotion. That is two strikes. They're going to try to steal and win the game, Lisa.
A washcloth.
Are you still rolling with a washcloth? No! If you fail to give it to me, they're going to play for the $10,000. You can win something that you squeeze to get more out of it. Monique, help her.
Shampoo.
Shampoo, Cindy?
Family budget.
Family budget, Michelle?
A cow's udder.
A cow's udder. Deborah Jo?
Ketchup, ketchup.
Tell her what you want her to say. You can win the game. You may go on your own, Dana.
Something. I'm going to say a ketchup bottle.
Something that you squeeze to get more out of it. Strangely enough, will you win the game with ketchup bottle? No! The centerfold of the 80s. Eat their bank. Let us see. This could have won you the game. Number three. Shampoo. Yeah! Who said shampoo bottle? Monique said it, but you didn't make Dana say it, so the team did not get it. Number four. We squeeze. Sponge, which is a cousin to a washcloth. I need two players right now for $10,000. The Playboy centerfolds of the 80s will be playing for the children of the night for $10,000 right after this. I wouldn't miss it. Special, as we put 15 seconds on that clock. The Playboy centerfolds of the 80s are playing for $10,000 for the children of the night. Good luck, Kimberly. We ask 100 people these five questions. Name something specific that just about everybody likes.
Ice cream.
The cost of a full tank of gas.
$12.
A part of the body people throw out of joint.
Shoulder.
An insect that invades your home.
Roach.
Something people should be loyal to.
Lover.
Turn around. Let us see how you did. Looking for $10,000 for that great charity. Something specific that just about everybody likes, you said? Ice cream. What did our survey say? 29. Very nice open. The cost of a full tank of gas, you said? $12. Must be a car made by Mattel. What did the survey say? $12 for 12 people. The part of the body people throw out of joint, you said. The shoulder in our survey said. 26, very nice. An insect that invades your home, you selected. Roach, survey said. 14, you're inching up. Something people should be loyal to. You said they should be loyal to their lover. What did our survey think? Zero. You can, I guess according to our survey, that doesn't really matter. 81 points, here comes. Karen, you can do this. You look straight ahead, you're 119 points away from $10,000 as 20 seconds goes on that clock, revealing the wonderful answers given by your partner for the children of the night, bring it home. We ask 100 people, name something specific that just about everybody likes.
Sodas.
The cost of a full tank of gas.
$15.
A part of the body people throw out of joint.
Shoulder.
Try again.
Knee.
An insect that invades your home.
Mosquitoes.
Something people should be loyal to.
Their spouse.
Turn around here. You need 119 points for that big comeback. Something specific that just about everybody likes, you said. Sodas, our survey said. Six only.
Oh, no.
Ice cream was number one. You got four chances to get to the 10,000. The cost of a full tank of gas, you thought? $15. What did our survey think? 29. What a difference $3 makes. 15, the number one answer. Part of the body people throw out of joint. You thought? The knee, and the survey said. Bam, you are inching up. What a difference. Knee, the number one answer. You're now 56 points away. An insect that invades your home, you said? The mosquito. Our survey said? Only six. Ants, the number one answer. All right, it comes down to this last question for $10,000. Something people should be loyal to. Lover did not make the survey, you said? To a spouse. That's a lot different than a lover. Yeah, I don't know why. But I'll tell you this. If 50 people said spouse, you've got $10,000. What did our survey say? the number one answer at $5 a point gives you. $975 for the children of the night. The centerfolds of the 80s did their best, and we're coming right back. Don't go away. For the Family Feud, I'm Ray Combs. See you next time. Bye-bye.
A member of our studio audience will receive Protect Your Idahoan. This is Gene Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. Meet Playboys, Miss September 1980, Lisa Welch-Semler. Miss July 1981, Heidi Sorensen. Miss January 1982, Kimberly MacArthur. Miss October 1989, Karen Foster. Miss June 1985, Devin DeVasquez. Centerfolds of the 1980s. Ready for action. Playing against Miss January 1976, Dana House. Playmate of the Year, 1978, Deborah Jo Fondren. Playmate of the Year, 1974, Cindy Wood. Miss May, 1979, Michelle Drake. Playmate of the Year, 1979, Monique St. Pierre. Centerfolds of the 1970. On your mark. For Family Feud's monumental, earth-shaking Battle of the Centerfold with the star of Family Feud, Ray Combs.
Thank you so very much. Hello to the centerfolds of the 70s. Welcome back to the lovely ladies and with the centerfolds of the 80s. Thank you so very much. Are you excited to be here? Well, we're glad that you've tuned in at home. You want to call a friend. It's by your popular demand. It's back. It is the Playboy Centerfold Special. You've already met the lovely ladies. They're playing for great charities. The Centerfolds of the 80s, headed up by Kimberly MacArthur. Welcome back. Now, the team that wins today will play for the chance at $10,000 for their favorite charity.
That's right.
Who'd you pick?
We picked the Children of the Night, which is a terrific organization. What it does is...